What you just saw were two friends of mine playing beanbag toss. The object of the game is to toss a beanbag across the yard and try and get it into the little hole. In this game, you do score a point if the beanbag lands onto the wooden platform, but you get 2 points if the bag goes into the hole. The game's similarities to horseshoes reminded me of an old saying, close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades. A close loss is still a loss. That applies to most games. Let's say you're watching a football game, your favorite team's down 17-16, but they can win the game on a last second field goal. Let's say the kicker lines up, kicks the ball, but the ball sails just to the left of the goalposts. If it doesn't split the uprights, no matter how close the kicker was to making the field goal, he doesn't score any points. The team loses. Or let's say you're watching a soccer game. Your favorite player is going for the winning kick. He kicks the ball, but it just misses the goal. He still doesn't score any points. His team still loses. Well, the same principle applies to receiving eternal life. In Mark chapter 12, verse 34, Jesus responded to a man who had answered a question wisely. He told this man, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." It reminds me, back in 1991, shortly after I gave my life to the Lord, I was having a talk with my sister, and she had commented that our parents were so close to becoming Christians. Both of them were raised in traditional type churches, but then they drifted into New Age beliefs. Well, a person can know a whole bunch of spiritual truths, but if they don't know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, they're on their way to hell. They must be born again. Jesus said in John 14:6, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Notice Jesus said he was the way, not a way. Now, fortunately, I had the honor of leading my mother to the Lord before she passed away, but I'm sure there's going to be many people that are going to stand before God's throne and thinking, "Oh, I was so close to getting saved." I've seen it happen many times when I've witnessed to people that have believed the gospel and they're ready to pray with me, but then a distraction comes up. Their cell phone rings. They decide to answer the call, or they're with someone who keeps telling them, "We got to go, we got to go." Now, hopefully, a lot of these people eventually got born again through other Christians witnessing to them. But I'm sure there's going to be a lot of people that are standing before God's throne thinking, "Oh, I was so close to getting saved." The Lord's going to remind them of missed opportunities. I don't want to see that happen to you if you need to get right with the Lord. If you're not sure you're going to heaven when your life ends, or you just know you're not in right standing with the Lord, I invite you to say a prayer like this with me and mean this in your heart. "God in heaven, I know I'm a sinner and I need your help. I believe Jesus Christ died on the cross and rose again from the dead. Jesus, come into my heart, be my Lord and Savior. Amen."